Recording in.
Hey traders, this is Scott. Welcome to the live room. So if you're new here, pay attention to the information in this video. We don't always go through all this stuff in class, so you will pick up some pieces here if you'll pay attention. So I got to do this, you know, this disclaimer. As you know, trading involves substantial financial risk, and this presentation, also our live room, is for educational purposes only and is not intended to induce anyone to initiate any investment or trade. Your trading results are entirely your responsibility. So who is this guy who's speaking? That's me on the left down there. I'm the co-founder of ProAct Traders, as is my partner, Jerry Rankin. I handle the live room and videos and tutorials, all the methodology, that stuff. Jerry handles the technical support and R&D. And constantly coming up with software and software additions. I have over two decades of trading and training experience. I was a Forex training consultant for FXDD. They were the second largest broker in the world at that time, and I did that for 3 years. I am also the author of The Empowered Forex Trader, Strategies to Turn Pains into Gains, and it's available on Amazon. There it is. All right, so we are here Monday through Thursday in the New York session. Monday night, we're here also in the weekly outlook room. We take a look at what might be a problem for this week, what to look for, and then we're going to look for our swing trade called the real estate of the week trade. And our traders make hundreds, if not thousands, of pips off that should that materialize. We are closed on Friday because Friday is square up day, and all retail traders should be flat in the market on Friday in the New York session. So why are you here? Well, our 20-year history with traders is you're here to replace or supplement your income. Some to retire, some to elevate their lifestyle, some to augment their lifestyle, but we are here to help you get through the steps it requires to become the trader who achieves that goal. It is not a get-rich-quick proposition, it is an evolution. So what do we do here? We teach price action, not indicators, and the methodology used by the big boys or the bankers to manipulate the market to their agenda and then send that information to knowledgeable traders around the world. We are part of the knowledgeable traders around the world. We created our own set of charts that show this methodology extremely well. This enables our traders to decipher that agenda message and use that information to create a trading plan for today. We trade only if we have a wide open space of 55 pips or more to the target. Education never stops here, and our motto is no trader left behind. So why are we different? Our business model is different. It's based on trader retention. Our methodology is different. We are target traders, not scalpers. And many of our traders make hundreds, sometimes thousands of pips every week. Our live rooms are interactive, a place you can really learn. Our charting software is different. Our chart template comes pre-set up and has multiple time frames simultaneously, including Heikinashi charts, has momentum signals that identify actual money entering and exiting the market, has special moving averages and a MACD and T3 to identify optimum trade areas, and has target tools available nowhere else. What are your results, you might say? Yes, we now have traders who are professionals. Our record is taken live and tabulated by a third party. It is published on our website. Seeing it is knowing you are in the right place. You will see that in the live room. You will also see that we as a group count only a small portion of what our traders actually accomplish. So we'll do pip captures after we look at the market, but our results are taken from actual trades our traders executed using our methodology and our software. We only count the one largest trade that each trader made, and that is divided by the number of traders who took it. And we must have a minimum of three traders in order for us to be able to count it. So you can see here that Daniel right there, four positions, we would only count the 1112. Daniel, there are four positions, we'd only count his 36. Notice up here, GJ, K, we'd only count her 116. But what did she make? 2,882 pips. As I said, hundreds and thousands of pips in this room. You'll see it. All right. Execution by our traders was due to an opportunity that we identified either live in a session recap or a heads up alert that was sent to them via the info center. We press our winners without exception, so you will see pip captures like I just showed you. We take opportunities only if we have a wide open space of 55 pips or more. We always press our winners. We use lots of entry orders. We will show you how to find these juicy spots based on price action in the charts. We trade live. We don't show you trades after the fact. Yeah, you could have got in here, man. No, we show it to you live. We first eliminate all the pairs that cannot give us a return on investment today. We will review all the clues that make certain pairs ripe for cherry picking. We will alert live what the trade setup is, typically a pull, a breakout, and pullback opportunities and areas that you can press your winners in. Enter when ready means that most, if not all, the entry conditions have been met. We do not call trades. The decision to make a trade is 100% yours. Enter when ready means enter when you are ready. Very important. We always press our winners without exception. And that means that you must place your second trade of today's plan before you take a market order for your first trade. We call this a snowman. Trade one is in the head. Trade two is in the body. Minimum wide open space is 55 pips or more. Looks like this in the charts. Trade one, a break resistance, break hook and go with 1/3 of our lots with 3 times the technical stop with a market order. Right there's the break hook and go, right? All right, trade two, break the next barrier, enter with 2/3 of your lots with an entry order. Trade one is then moved, the stop is moved to break even, and we manage all trades once in profit by moving stops. Our goal for you, 65-35. 65% win ratio. By the way, that means you lose 35 out of 100 trades and a 35 plus average pip capture. If you can do those two numbers, you are sustainable for the rest of your trading career. You need to trade only micros until you get close to those numbers. What about stops? We always trade with real stops, not mental ones. We have a special stop policy that allows us to trade with those big boys in their arena, but with our smaller accounts. We will show that to you live. Entries always are an even number. Stops, always an odd number ending in a 3 or a 7. Option contracts use a 5, so we don't want to mess with those boys. We are here to teach you to fish. If you give a man a fish and you feed him for a day, you fed him for a day. But if you teach a man how to fish, and then you have fed him for a lifetime. Our focus is twofold. Use a live trade to teach trade execution. Help traders move to their personal next level so they are in the journey to replace or supplement their income. Where's the trade? Where's the trade? Where's the trade? All right. At the many trades we identify may start in this session, but usually do not finish in this session. By the way, if we get one that does, I'll make a special video of it because it's very rare. That does not change the trading opportunity if the dollar index is still provable. We will then do a session recap video at the end of the session for our worldwide subscribers that is posted in the Info Center, the IC, and also in the Academy. Do you send trade signals? No, we are not a signal service. We do, however, send heads up alerts to our subscribers via the Info Center. These are trade ideas, areas that I've looked at and said, man, if this goes, it could be good. That does not mean it's a trade signal. They are potentially actionable ideas, but you must qualify them based on your criteria. Typically, I send 4 alerts per day, Monday through Thursday, at the New York fix. You need to know where that is in your time zone. And alerts are membership specific. They look like this. You'll get a buy or a sell. You'll get the currency. You'll have an entry price, a stop price, and a limit. Those are general areas. They're not signals, remember. And then what do you got to do after a break, hook, and go? So let's do a little housekeeping. No swearing in the chat or risk being dismissed. No sound, just log out and come back in. Please use your real name in the chat, not Big Daddy Forex or the Pip Dude, et cetera, et cetera. We are a family, and as such, we use our real first names. If you're new to target trading, there are no dumb questions. We record everything, and this recording will be available in the Academy in about an hour after we close the room. So if I said something, you go, man, I'd like to hear that again. Well, you can. Just go take a look at it. We allow no discrimination of any kind. We have all races, nationalities, and religions here. And by the way, we all get along.
So please keep all negative comments out of this room. We do dismiss people who do that. So just a heads up.
You will initially learn 4 entry strategies. The number one trade to learn is the pole trade. We'll show it to you in class, all right? We find a rectangle or a flag, and then we have a specific way to tell what it's going to try to do. So it's the number one trade to learn first, because you can earn while you learn. You'll then learn some strategies for entering a trade, break, hook, and go, close and reverse, and before you enter, let it center. We also have a 6 aces reversal setup. It's for more accomplished traders and should not be attempted by a novice trader yet. Wow, it's kind of overwhelming. Yeah, but it's a process. First day's here. Be a sponge. Just listen and watch. Right? Ready to jump in? Start with the first videos course in the Academy. I wonder why we called it the first videos course. If you're a beginner, tackle the beginner's course in the Academy. If you're ready to try our amazing charting software, just sign up for a demo. The Academy opens up from beginner level up to fast trackers, and there are 15 separate courses in the Academy. Our trade today, if we find one, will be filtered by the ATR, or the average true range. Membership options include the ATR in the IC. It looks like this. The average ATR is the average daily movement in pips for each pair. We use the 14-day column because Wilder, who invented it, said that's what you do. But we have the ability to compare. So you can see right here, Aussie New Zealand, right? All right, is currently doing 6 pips a day. That's what we'll use for our target. Last week, though, it was doing 57, so it's a little stronger than last week. But in the bigger picture, it's slightly less than it's normal. But in reality, overall, in the course of a year, it's running right where it's supposed to be, 66, 68 pips a day, all right? So it's a very powerful tool that allows you to identify a viable target and also determine whether you have a target that you can even trade today. Do I have enough room? So our first qualifier is, do we have at least 55 pips to the ATR target? If we do not, we pass on the pair, all right? And why? Because we cannot press our winners. There is no room. The secret to being successful in the Forex is pressing your winners without exception. You can't do it with less than 55 pips. So we're going to go in the charts now and take a look and see what we've got for today. So I'll see you in the room in just a second. But today we have a fundy. That's a news announcement. All right. So you need to be flat in any pair that may be affected by this announcement. We will predetermine the target of 55 or more pips. We will wait for a reaction on the 1-minute chart. All right. We only trade if the fundy continues the current structure. We do not take trade reversals. Wait for a 3 to 5 minute sideways move or a break of support or resistance. We will place all trades as entry orders, not market orders. We will review it live. So let's take a look.
Good morning, everybody. This is Scott. Hopefully you're doing great this morning. Morning. Thank you, George. Thank you, Larry. All right. Morning, John. So you can see, as we thought yesterday, initially had it down, but then I sent you an alert later saying it looks like they're going to push it up. So they did push it up, but now they've come right back where they are. So that may be the last stand on this currency, on the dollar index. And you can see you have divergence in play. So once we break this bottom, we're looking for that move right there. Will it happen? I don't know. It's trying, but we'll see what happens here. I'm just going to put slope support across this bottom last piece here, and that'll show us where that breakout occurs if it does. So above here, you're still a buyer. Below here, you're now a seller. Right now, we are in between because we could be transitioning from a buy to a sell. So we'll let the charts tell us what it's doing. All right, and as you can see, pretty dramatic immediately. So we had a push to the downside during the night on the euro, and it pushed back up completely opposite of the dollar, which is normal, right? So we can't trade the euro dollar because it has too low an ATR. And let me pull it up here, euro dollar. And euro dollar is 51 pips is all she can do. 51 pips, which is about 14 pips a session. That's it. So there you go. Nothing to do on that one for sure. Pound dollar, right? Uh-huh. Making the turn now. They started down last night when the dollar went up. But right now, I already had it up last night, and it was an alert for last night. We'll see if we break up into this area right in here now. And I'm going to put slope resistance across the top. And you can see you're in a break and a hook right now. Okay, let's go see what the three musketeers say about that. All right, so the three musketeers are these three charts down here, Heikinashi charts. And they tell us who's in control of the currency, what's the order flow. We're trying to turn it up. Order flow is up. We're trying to turn it up. Then we validate that with three oscillators. Yep, we're going up. Yep, we're going up. Yep, we're going up. And we were going up. All right. So this is the hook. It's showing you the hook right there. All right. So we have a break and a hook. So that gives us permission to go back down here to the 10. And now you can see you're in the go. All right. So you got to put an entry order in. If you're going to trade this, your entry order is above here. That's trade one, two. This is trade one right here. All right. So pound dollar, this is on tap right now, but unfortunately, you don't want to take it before the announcement, right? So here we go, pound dollar, ATR is 71 pips, all right? So there you go. Entry order above 26.62, 26.64, looking for 27.20 up there, okay? Pound dollar on the table for a buy, right? We can't trade the Swissy, but we can check it for the dollar, all right? So as you can see, coming down pretty hard right now. Take out this bottom. We're looking to go down here. I'm going to go ahead and take this channel off now. And we'll be, you see, MACD's clearly telling you, hey, you've got divergence. You're going to go down. All right, can't trade it, though, because it only has a 53-pip ATR, 54-pip ATR, so you can't trade it. If you don't have 55 pips, you don't. And we don't even have 55 pips to start with, let alone where we are. All right. Dollar yen blog post this morning. We got a break and a hook. We're looking for come down into this area right down in here. The target is 150.50. Dollar yen has 103 pip ATR. Three musketeers. What do they say? Three musketeers say, yeah, we're going down. We were going down. We're trying to, we're stalled out right now. Yeah, we're going down. We're going down, and we're about to close up to go down. All right. So there you go. Confirmer says, you're just barely starting. All right. So we've got a break and a hook that gives us permission to go to the 10. All right. So now we go to the 10, and we see here that we have broke hook. We're waiting for the go to the downside. Entry order would be above one, below 151, 158, 150.98, 97.6, something like that. For that trade right there, that gives you the snowman. The whole trade is right here, right there. And this would be trade one, and this is trade two. See how you can see it so easily, all right? So how do I trade that? Okay, this is trade one. This is trade two. All right, I trade one with one third of my lots with three times the technical stop. Trade two is two thirds of my lots. When trade two goes in, trade one stop has to go to break even minimum, maybe even profitable. and then you hold it. And as you get close to the target down here, it becomes a one-to-one risk to reward ratio. I'm 8 pips away from the target. All my stops are 8 pips away from the target. All right. You don't need to be in a hurry to move your stops, but you do need to move your stops if you have a mathematical reason to do so. All right. So there we go. Let the currency has to breathe. So you need to get, need to give it a chance to do that. All right. So dollar yen's on the table for a sell, following the dollar index down. All right. Can't trade either the Aussie or the New Zealand because the APRs are too low. Aussie is 47 pips and New Zealand is 44 pips. Just unbelievably low. All right. So let's see what we're going to trade in the announcement. We've got pound dollar here and how many pips we got. Let's go work it up. All right. So here's where this little tool comes in handy to you. Okay. We take the trip calculator. All right. Let me close this one out here. All right. So our first entry is going to be anywhere right in here. Let's call it 126.40. All right. 126.40. All right. The target is 27.20. 127.20. All right. And that means the first trade has got 80 pips in it. You can see there. All right. The second entry is above 62.26.64. 12664. All right. And we don't have a third entry. We don't have enough space to do that. This trade's worth 192 pips to you. If you execute correctly and the market cooperates, all right? Those are the two caveats. So good trade right there on the pound dollar for 192 pips. Let's go work up the dollar yen and see what that looks like. All right. So dollar yen, we're going to take our first trade at 151.30 roughly. All right. Target price is 150.50 down here, right there. All right. So first trade has got 80 pips in it. All right. The second entry is going to be below 150.98. All right. There we go. And this trade's worth 176 pips. So you can see they're pretty close, but the pound dollar is a better trade, but only by 5 pips. So it's really a matter of you, what you want to do. We have to have dollar weakness, right? If it comes out dollar negative, we can trade the UJ down, and we can also trade the pound dollar up, right? Other than that, we can't trade anything, all right? So we'll see what happens here. They're going to stall out. Don't worry about them. They're just trying to telegraph right now. This is all about telegraphing their intention, all right? So they broke it quick. Why'd they do that? So that everybody knows we're trying to go up, all right? That's why, all right? So, take them at their word. All right, so either one of those will be good, UJ or GU. Remember, you never take a trade unless you are, it continues the structure that's already in play, all right? If it goes against the structure in play, you just pass and let it go away because it's going to be a blip on the screen, right? All right, let's see if we get an indirect relationship on the euro-yen, all right? With the euro-yen dollar coming down, this should be all that you're going to do because if the dollar comes down, EJ goes to the upside. Now, we did not take our target out here, as you can see. So let me go back to the ATR right here and euro-yen. We have an ATR of 112 pips. Right? We now have a new bottom in place. So we take the new bottom in place. We did not do our ATR overnight. So it can do it again, 112. Right? So that target would be up there. Right? I'm going to leave this on because it was the alert from last night. All right. So now let's go check and see what the three musketeers say. And they say, we're going down. No, we're trying to turn it. We're trying to turn it. And we did turn it. All right. So it's going to be a long time before the confirmer tells you what you're doing here. So you got to be above that T3. All right. So I'm going to put slope resistance across this top. And I'm taking this right here. And you go, how did you know to ignore those two? All right. Once you do 300 of them, you'll know what to do. All right. Your brain will automatically tell you, just ignore those two. Take this one. Above here, we're a buyer, all right? So we've got to get and we're below the zero line right now. So the trade is up here, right there. Trade one will be here. Trade two will be here, and you'll hold for the double top up here. All right, so UJ to the upside, not to the down, and it hasn't happened yet. All right, so there we go. All right, let's check the GJ. All right, so we're ready to go for the alarm, announcement this morning. All right, pound yen got a breakout here. Most likely that's real. All right, so you already have convergence for the upside move. So we're going to take this off. We don't get married to anything here. And we'll take this off to the downside, and we're going to go to the upside. All right, so I'm going to take the swing low over here to the swing high, back to the swing low right there. And that shows me where the 1,000 is. So I know that that's a viable target this morning. I'm going to put slope resistance across the last piece right there. And you can see you're in a breakout right now looking for that opportunity up there. Pound yen has an ATR of 133 pips. All right. So we go over here, grab that, and find out. And this is the new low for the day. We take the low for the day. We're going up to 133 pips. And there's the target right there. And we do have enough room here. All right, so you can see the trade. The whole trade is here. You'd hold to the 1270 above there, and that's the trade. And here is trade one is right here on this breaking hook. Can't take it right now. And then you're going to trade up here, right there. All right, pound yen to the upside. And that's very close to happening. All right, so there you go. All right, we can come back later and figure out the exact trade and how many pips it's worth for to us. That little tool is just going to help you like crazy. It's going to show you better trades. That's what it's going to do. Show you a better trade. Don't waste your money over here. You can make 60 pips here, but you can make 140 over here. Let's go make 140. All right, Aussie yen. All right, was a session recap for yesterday. Remember, we had a false breakout. I told you I'm going to wait and see if it breaks back in. It did break back in. There it is. Gave us about 60 pips there. And Aussie yen has a 74 pip ATR. Now it's going to reverse here, so let's make sure it didn't do its ATR first. All right, so 1600 is right here. We put the high end up here, all right, and we're going down for 74 pips. You see, they already did it, all right, to the pip. I wonder if they knew where that was. Gee, I don't know, Scott. It went right to the ATR, stopped dead. That means there's no trade here because it's already done its ATR. It's possible to do the ATR both ways, all right? But we won't trade it both ways, all right? Because that's a statistical probability. So it's already achieved its goal. It's done for the day, all right? Euro Aussie, we'll see if traders got it, all right? Euro Aussie, all right? Now, it's been trying to move up with the dollar, but with the dollar coming down, you see, it's just chop city here, right here. So we don't really want this until we get out of this chop down in here. And that's going to be a long time from now, most likely. But we'll figure it out anyway. Euro Aussie, 77 pip ATR, and I can get a 1,000 on here from the swing low to the swing high to the swing low to the swing high. 1,000's right there. All right, 77 pip ATR, really coming down. That's the high for the day right there. And we're going to come down for 77 pips. And there we go. All right, so you can see they basically did their ATR up. So walk away from the Euro Aussie. It's there, but we don't want to trade in this mess. This is a big, big mess right here. Right there. That's a whole big mess. Just stay out of it. All right. You see, it's chop city. You'll get eaten alive in there. Those are all, just think of these candles are all piranhas. These are all piranhas and you want to jump in the water. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. That's probably not going to work. Swiss yen. All right. So Swiss yen trying to make the breakout up, and it is pushing through. We'll get rid of this now. Get ready for it. And I'm going to take that off to the downside, take this off to the downside. All right. We're going to put slope resistance across the top right here. There we go. And now you can see you're clearly in a breakout there. Take this off to the downside. Remove, take the HSI off to the downside. That's it. We'll leave the fibs because they're telling us they're using them. All right. So we need to find a 1,000 up there. So swing low. Swing high, swing low right there. 1,000 are almost to it right now. Swiss yen got a nice ATR, 121 pip ATR. Find the 5 o'clock candle from yesterday, 1600. And where are you? Right in here. here, and we put a low in after it. We'll take the low, and we're going up for 121 pips. Right? Remember, the ATR is a swing low, swing high of the day chart every day. All right, we still got, looks like plenty of room. Let me just check that, especially if we get a pullback, because we couldn't buy here anyway. 55 pips, we're right at 55 pips right now. Well, we can't buy it here because we'll be buying at the top. So it has to pull back down. They'll most likely stall out before the announcement, pull back down, all right? Then once it pulls back down, trade two is already, wherever this stops is where trade two is, wherever that stops. So trade two is there. Pull back down in here, and there you got trade one. So only if the Swiss yen pulls back do you have a trade. But if you do, you got one right there. All right. Get rid of that. Over to pound Aussie. All right. Pound Aussie. Ooh, got a big move already to the upside already. Let's see how, if we have anything left on this one. Pound Aussie, 94 pip ATR. And find the 5 o'clock candle, 1600 right in here. Put a low in after that, which is way down there. And we're going up for 94 pips. And you can see there is nothing left. Right? They did it easily, plus another. So that'll raise the ATR tomorrow, which will be nice. Nothing there. Right? You're in New Zealand. All right, almost a target right now is an alert from last night. We'll see if traders got it. So nothing to do. It's already happened. And hopefully we have traders in it. Pound New Zealand, same thing here. All right, so let's see what happens on this one. Pound New Zealand, you can see they already did their ATR pretty easily, 101 pip ATR. Find the 5 o'clock candle from yesterday, 1600. Where are you? Right in here, right there. We put a low in after that. We take the low. We're going up for 101 pips, 101. We're a buyer, and you can see. Already did it through the pip right there and added a little extra. That'll raise the ATR tomorrow. That's already happened too. Over to New Zealand yen. And as we talked about yesterday, okay, thanks, Jerry. Thanks, Jerry. Okay. As you can see, yesterday we were here. We saw the bear flag. We said, but we can't trade into a range bottom or a day chart bottom. Now, they went ahead and did it, but it's too dangerous for us to do it. But it's already happened, so it's done. And New Zealand yen had a 61 pip ATR, barely able to trade it. Find the 5 o'clock candle, 1600. We put a high in after that, going down for 61 pips. 61, and voila. Easily went to target. There we go. All right. Thanks, Jerry. All right. Pound Swissy has a 66 pip ATR. So we can trade that if we get an opportunity. And you can see it's following the dollar. It does that half the time. Right now it's doing that. All right. And can I get a fib on here? Yeah, I can. I want to, I'll adjust this later once I get a move down and a pullback here. All right. So we already hit the 1000 there. All right, pound Swissy, 66 pip ATR. Find the 5 o'clock candle from yesterday, 1600. We put a high in after that. We take the high, go down 66 pips, and you can see there's nothing left for us. We only got about 30 pips left. All right, so it's down to, in the announcement, we're going to trade either the pound, they're both virtually the same, pound up. We're going to trade the dollar yen down. All right, down. It's already, see, they're already telegraphing their intention. See that? But the problem is that they're eating up pips for us. Right now, this is not a problem for them because this is trade two for them. But because they traded, they remember, they're market makers. They make the market work. All right. So they're in, that's trade one is when they made it break the symmetrical triangle. Now we got a break and a hook. Now they're making the next move. All right. All right. So that's pound yen. That's dollar yen to the downside. We can trade euro yen up, but it's not going to be here for a while. And pound yen, we're right here at a breakout. So we could trade pound yen as a better trade because it's here. The UJ still got a ways to go. This is already here. We can go down to the 10-minute chart. And as you can see, they're just up. They broke. They're holding for the announcement. Let's hope we get a little pull back down into here, and then you got trade one here and trade two up there. See how easy it is to see the trade? All right, it's easy. If you get your lines on your charts correct, trade one is there and trade two is there. The chart will tell you where to trade it, all right? So pound yen looking pretty good there. right? And the only exotic we got is a CJ. And CJ is, yeah, it's got to pull back, all right? So, you got a rule that says you never buy at the top. So you know you can't touch this one because you're at the top of this candle. So you got to have a pullback, all right? The pullback is your friend, all right? Always remember, the pullback is my friend, all right? So pullbacks are your friend. So Jerry added a clear entry on the risk calculator. Okay. Down here. Clear entry right there. Okay, there it is. So as your account grows, you clear it and start all over again. And stop calculator, same thing. Back to main menu. Stop calculator. Clear the entries so you can start all over again. There we go. All right. So there we have it. All right. Anybody got any questions on any of that? Still got 9 minutes before the announcement. Right. So you use your IC to go there right here. Fundies, just click there and it'll bring them up. And it'll be right in here. We're waiting for it right now. All right. So. And we got pending home sales, and we got revised University of Michigan sentiment. So those are the two announcements coming out at the same time. They could conflict, and everything would stay the same. They could both be negative, and everything will rock, or it could all be positive, and everybody will go, who cares? Why? Because it's all about using a fundamental to be a catalyst to continue the structure, right? Big boys make the structure. Big boys invest millions, if not billions of dollars. In fact, it is millions because the original, the lowest trade at the bank level is $1 million. And that's not leverage money. That's actual $1 million. Right? So billions of dollars it can cost them to build a structure. Right? Once they build a structure, which costs them a lot of money, they need to get a return on investment. That's the whole purpose of the market makers. Create a structure where everybody will want to take it to our agenda, right? That's all there is to it, right? Now, we trade with the follow-through. The follow-through is 1,000 banks in the interbank market trading between each other. The market makers, the top 10, 15 bankers, they create that structure, but they do not take it to target. It's the 1,000 traders who all have at least $1 million account, because the lowest trade you can trade on the interbank market is $1 million. And most of them have one to two traders per bank, all right? So 1,000 banks times two traders would be 2,000 traders times at least $1 million, all right? So you can see it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money. And that's why we do $7-8 trillion a day. All right, got 6 minutes left for these three announcements coming out right here. And we'll see what happens, all right? Not much to do other than that, but wait. Sorry to all the fast trackers yesterday. I am, you know, we added this platinum room and I'm just not used to it yet. I mean, I'm used to doing Monday nights, but I'm not used to Wednesday. And so I set an alarm last week to alert me, but I forgot to put recurring alarm. So when I did it last week, it was all it did. It didn't alert me this week. I got that changed now, but it was my fault. Man, totally. All right. So we will do it today. All right. Yeah, we won't count it, Robert. We will do it today. We'll have the platinum room for all fast trackers. Okay. So there we go. So I do have it today. I do know how to do it. I got a post-it note staring at me right now. It says platinum. It's okay. You were. Oh, okay. Good for you. Hopefully you caught some big bass. So there we go. All right, got about 5 minutes to go. Yeah, that's exactly right, Joe. I was testing you guys. That's exactly correct. Not. So, anyway, not much to do. Anybody got any questions? Let me check this cheat sheet again. Hold on. Let me check the cheat sheet. So this is, let's see if we have anything here. This is new home sales, right? So if it's deviated by 70,000, it'll produce a 70 pip move, all right? So be aware of that. 70,000 jobs less or more, it'll produce a 70 per pip move, all right? So that's what this is all about right here, right? So it's new home sales today. I think it's new home sales, isn't it? Yeah. Pending home sales. Well, that's different. Pending home sales. I don't know. That's everything. So it's added in here. All right. So about 4 minutes to go. And remember, we're trading the UJ and the GU. Now, remember how you do this. All right. Let's just go take a look at this. We've got a minute or two here. All right. So pull it up. All right. They took out the ones that is, see, there's no room left on the UJ now. All right, so the UJ is off. They already did it. But there's no 55 pips left. There's only 30 pips left. All right, so that isn't going to work. So it's now the pound dollar. And they're still telegraphing, folks. Look at how they're telegraphing. They are making sure everybody knows this is what we want to do. All right, so this will go, when the announcement comes out, we get down to the 1 minute chart. All right. And there will be a reaction, and we need the reaction to the upside. Now, sometimes they'll flip it down to flip it up to get more pips to the downside. And we don't want to be any part of that. That's a whipsaw. Right. So when it goes sideways and it'll come up here, react, and eventually it'll go sideways for three to five candles. Once you know where that is right there, your entry order is above there for trade one, and you already have trade two in. So you can put trade two in right now at 126.64. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do it on the pound dollar. Hold on. 126.64. So I got a pending order in. I got my second trade in, just waiting for trade one. Now, why do I have the confidence to do that? Because, well, first of all, I've done it a long time, but that's not the big deal. The big deal is it pushes up here, which they've already telegraphed what they're doing. If they push up here, they're going to try to go to target up here, and that's the opportunity. It's 60 pips up there with two lots is 120 pips. Plus, if I get this one down here, whatever it'll give me down here, plus the 60 pips up here. See? So this trade could be worth, 200 pips plus. Right? We'll see. 2 minutes to go, folks. All right. A minute and 20 seconds. And Forex Live is a little quicker than Forex Factory. So you might get it before we get it over there. One minute to go. Yes, Larry, 1 o'clock Eastern time. Thirty seconds. Drivers, take your mark. It's in the fast track room, Robert, because it's only fast trackers. So. 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All right, we're all waiting for them to post it. Let's see if it's positive or negative. No hurry in the Forex. All right, so it's positive, right? Dollar positive on both of those. That's not good for us, right? So positive means that the dollar will go up. Watch this thing now, because that you know, the dollar is going to go up, which it should, right? Or they may just say, ho hum, who cares? Let's get rid of it. Who cares? We're doing this. Right? See this thing we're doing over here? We ain't doing that anymore. That's what that means. All right, so you see they're breaking it. All right, so don't be in a hurry here. Right? Do not be in a hurry. It came out opposite of what we wanted to come out. Right? So now it's a matter of whether they're going to ignore it or not. You can see they did not ignore it here. They went ahead and took that trade. So we needed to go sideways. Three, to ensure that it is going up and that they're holding at a certain level. Break of that level, whatever that is where our opportunity for trade one is. Trade two is already in. Right? So don't forget it. You already got trade two posted. And that's the same you do every time. You always place trade two first anyway. If you're not doing that and you're just looking for an entry, you're not planning the trade. You're not doing what you need to do. You need to plan the trade, and trade two goes in first. After that, you see if you can get the entry order. Right? And there'll be times when you put a market order in just to make sure you get it. I mean, an entry order in to make sure you get it. Right? So far, not much reaction here. Right? So you can see if it stays below the T30 here, if it stays below, you could put it right above the T30 at 26.54. Well, you're going to have to pull back down in here somewhere. We've got two candles now at this top right here. So this is the top that's got to be broken, as you can see. They already put in a higher high in the 1 minute, so that's a good sign. And this pullback will be really nice if it does, right? And don't forget, it's all done with entry orders, right? Why do we do it with entry orders? Because it has to prove that it's going to follow. It's a reaction. It's a knee-jerk reaction to this announcement, right? So is it going to go up? I don't know. It shouldn't go up. In reality, it should not, because of the announcement. But as you can see, they're trying to push it through on the dollar. Right? So there's all what ifs. I mean, trading is all about what if. What if it does this? What if it does that? What if it does this? What if it does that? So all those what ifs are questions, and those what ifs are answers that you have to find from the charts. Your job is to be an information gatherer. That's what your job is, right? So gather the information. My experience with traders is they are lousy at it, right? They're just looking for a, you know, just give me something that says buy or sell. That's all I want, man. You know, like in way back in the old days when we had Forex Made Easy, we had these big red and green arrows on a piece of software. You didn't even look at a chart. If it went red, you bought. If it went green, you sold. If it went green, you bought. You had no idea what it was doing. And man, traders lined up to buy that thing. It was like $10,000. They made millions and millions and millions of dollars, and eventually found out that it doesn't work, and they got sued, and I don't remember what happened to them, but anyway, they got sued, and it was terrible. But a lot of traders in my generation, that's how they got into the forex, all right? Because Forex Made Easy, basically Forex Made Easy made the retail market. That's what they did. They made the retail market. Now, once people figured out they were losing with that software, they realized that it's a zero-sum game. So they were losing, somebody was winning. Whatever they were losing, somebody was winning it. And so that kept them in the market. And now we started to learn to trade. In those days, all we had was scalping. I mean, I was a scalper. I taught people how to scalp. All right, that's what we knew how to do. All right, until one day I had a paradigm shift, said, so it doesn't work. That's correct, John. It's the same room. Yeah, John, market analysis and fast track are both the same room. Thanks, so, John. All right, not a whole lot of reaction here from the dollar. So that means that we probably won't get much reaction here. Ooh, pulling down is nice. All right, now, with this pull down here, pull back down here, you can go, especially if it pulls down in here, you could place your entry order above right where we are right now, if it'll come down in this area here. for the up move. Now remember, if it follows the index, the announcement, it's going to keep moving down. So you don't have a lot of risk on these two trades here. They only get executed if the currency tries to do it. And if the currency tries to do it, we want to be in on it. See, so it's not a lot of risk, right? There's always risk. That's, you signed up for risk when you became a trader, right? Look, there's always risk. What we're trying to do is minimize that risk, right? So this pullback will give us a little bit more to the top, right? So we'll see. We got, five candles out now, and we're not able to go. So you have no room to. It's got 60 pips up here. Let me look at it here. Oh, wait a second. You're right, Larry. That's left over from last night. I forgot to move it. I'll be that way. I'll just put you on 71 pip APR. Thanks, Larry, for the heads up. So yeah, we don't have any room. So we don't have this trade. All right, we're done. Let me get rid of that pending order. All right, nothing there. Thanks, Larry. All right, so GU is off the table. All right, so it looks like we're going to have to trade the EJ or the GJ. EJ is not here yet. GJ, you're going to do it? Yeah, it is. Okay. All right, so we got a pullback here. All right, trade two is up here. You got to have it already in. All right, above 191.33, 191.36 would be good on the pound yen. Let me do that. He's not very far away. All right, I got a pending order at 91.36, and I'm looking to get a market order on this pullback. All right, so GJ, nice. Let's go check that CJ. Yeah, it's nothing here now. See, it's all gone. So CJ is off the table. There we go. Notice perfectly. Notice this. This is why you go find the 1,000. Whatever that is right there is what they're going to do here. It's going to equal to the pip. Do you think they knew where the 1,000 was? Yes, they do. All right? Because it's 100%. The pullback gave them a chance to do 100% of whatever the first move was. They all recognized it was 90 pips. Let's not miss this, baby. And they made it, see? And that's what you got to get good at, all right? So you can see A, B, C, all right? What's next? A four wave and then a five wave. Wow, then we have a channel to the upside. We'll see. Now, if it's going to go down, it's finishing A, B, C. So now it can go to the downside. But you won't take that. Why? Because MACD tells you you're a buyer. So you leave it alone. Why? Because it's 82% going to go in that direction. All right. So what's going to happen? Well, it's at the top. You can't buy at the top. Neither can any other buyers. They can't buy it. Only dumb money does that. So they're most likely pull it down or do a flag here. All right. Most likely. So we'll see. We'll see. All right. Not a whole lot left. GJ, EJ, if we break up into there. Well, if we break up there, I don't think we have 55 pips, do we? Yeah, we do. We got plenty of room up there. If we can break up in that area, we got plenty of room. All right. Craig, you want to do pip captures for us? While we're waiting. Okay, great. All right. So first thing I do is I said I have dollar down. First push down, it may not be ready yet. If it reverses, replot targets in reverse, okay? Then later I looked at it again and I came back here and I said, dollar, showing candle up, watch for the reversal. So I gave you a heads up that it was gonna reverse and go up. All right, so back to the alerts. And the first one that went was the EJ, which is right here. Oh, it's pound dollar, hold on. Right here, EJ. EJ was a sell. It was a buy. So remember, that means you, that when it went up, you sold. Instead, you flipped it. So it was, you would have sold it here for that target right there. Right? You had to flip it because the dollar flipped. Right? Everything was based on that. Anybody flip it and take the EJ to the downside instead of to the upside? EJ. 57 for K. Nice. Anybody else? Only K traded it. Well, nice job, K. Woo-hoo-hoo! Woo! Good job. All right, so nobody in the EJ. And then the other one I had was the Euro New Zealand. I'll go back here. Euro New Zealand. There. All right. Euro New Zealand, I had it as a sell. When it flipped, you flip it up, right? So there we go. Euro New Zealand to the upside instead of to the downside. Originally, I had it down here, but when the dollar flipped, it went the other way. All right, almost a target right now. Anybody trade Euro New Zealand up? No? Okay. All right, anybody trade the AJ? All right, then we had a false breakout yesterday, so I want to wait for it to see if it comes back in. It sure enough did, went to the pip, to its ATR. Anybody trade AJ down? AJ down? Okay, nobody traded that. And finally for me is the pound New Zealand. Once it flipped, you need to flip this and go up. We were looking for it to break out yesterday. It was real choppy right there. See the difference? And finally did the nap. We're going up and up they went. There you go. So much for that rising wedge. Anybody trade pound New Zealand up? Pound New Zealand up. Okay, nobody traded that. All right, that's it for me. If you traded something else, you'd like to post it. We'd like to see it. We don't count it, but we'd like to see it. Thanks, Craig, as always. And thanks, Larry, yesterday. Appreciate you. I forgot to thank you, Larry, yesterday. So thank you. All right, everybody calm and collected, I guess. Okay, thank you, Craig. CJ sell 89.5534. Gee, Robin, I wonder if you like those fib numbers. I don't know. What do you think, everybody? 89.5534. Of course, you're going the other way, but still. All right. So you look at Robin's trade, 89 pips, plus she had 55 times 2, that's 110. Then she has 34 times 3, that's 96 or whatever it is, right? So the CJ was 300 pips for Robin potential. 300 pips with three trades in there. Pretty sweet. Not bad, Robin. So in fact, I'm going to give you this song today. Here you go, Robin. Yeah, I like it a lot. I like it. And a nice big ATR too, Robin. Big ATR and technically traded. I'm sure glad we brought that in, got rid of that CAD yen. CAD yen was nasty. All right. So what do we got? We only got the GJ. We have dollar yen maybe. Yeah, dollar yen to the down. It's not pushing, see, because the announcement came out positive. So the dollar is going to have a hard time going down with a positive news, right? So this is a fundy. The fundy will eventually work its way out, and that's it. I wonder if they know where that 382 fib is. Gee, I don't know. That's Scott. He's so lucky. But if we get this break here, looking for a break hook and go right there. Trade one is there. Trade two is there. Beautiful trade. Let's go see what it's worth. All right. So pop up our trip calculator. All right. So this is, I mean, once you start using this, folks, you're going to be going, oh, man, I'm so glad I got this thing. First entry, what are we going to do? Take the break of the 151.20. So we'll do 151.18, 151.18. All right. The target is 150.50, 150.50. All right. Second entry is the 150.98. All right. We don't have room for a third. Actually, we do, but we won't put it. If you place the third order down, third one down below here, you can make a ton of pips. So it's worth 164 pips. Anybody interested in that? That's because trade two has two lots in it. So it doesn't have to go as far to make even more money than trade one, which is going to go the furthest. See? And this is why you trade this way, because you're stacking the deck in your favor. You're making the numbers work for you as opposed for the numbers working for the bank or the broker. So not a bad opportunity on dollar yen. So dollar yen and pound yen basically are it. That's what we got. And we might get the EJ if it moves quickly. And it's not moving very quickly, as you can see. They got to get up into this area here. I can take this one off now. All right. So because we're done with that one from the downside on the EJ. Nobody traded it. Crazy. Flows in reverse to the downside. We're below the MACD. So, and it's already done its ATR to the downside. So now, that's correct. That's the way to execute, right? First trade is one lot. Second trade is two lots. Third trade is three. Now, you don't have to trade three on the third lot. It depends on your margin size, all right? But what you're basically doing, Stephen, is you're taking the profit from trade one, which is one lot, trade two, which is two lots, and you're saying, okay, I still got 35 pips left. I have no risk because I have profit. I'm going to take that profit. I'm going to risk it again, all right? And then we go. There we go. So it's pretty cool. And then what it'll do also, Stephen, is force you to trade like that. It'll force you to trade like that because the numbers work if you trade like it's telling you to trade, see? So there's a lot of psychological stuff going into it, not just the fact that we got a cool little widget, but there's some psychological stuff going on too, you know? But, we probably aren't going to get the EJ this morning, but we might get the pound yen if it'll go up. Right? Now, I got an entry order up there, but you know, it's not moving that way yet. So remember, you never take a fundy unless it continues the move. So if this decides to continue the move that's already been established, which was the breakout, if it continues that move, we will trade it. If it doesn't continue that move, we won't. And that's just it. So traders have a tendency to think that when you're going to go trade, it's about making trades. It's not that at all. It's about figuring out which one or two max is going to give you a return on investment today. All right? That's the whole point. And you know, this is business. It's a business. All right? It's a return on investment. What is my investment? The spread and my margin. All right? If I don't have a stop on my trade, I have all of my margin at risk. As soon as I put a stop on, I have reduced my risk. All right? So that's why you always trade with stops. You don't trade with a mental stop. You actually put the stop in. But in this case, it's three times the original stop. All right? So it's three times the technical stop. So you can figure it out right here. We'll do it on this one with using the calculator. We go back here. We go to the stop calculator. All right. So let's say we're going to take this at 191.10. 191.10. All right. And you can see on the 10-minute chart, the last support was right here, which is at low 190.90. All right. 190.90, right? Now, that's the technical stop, right? So the stop value that you put in down here would be 190.50, right? So your stop would be right here, right? Three times the stop. So this is your actual risk right there. And then you go three times that, put it at 190.50, right there, whatever that is, 190. I didn't draw very well, okay? Then trade two is up here, right? Now, as soon as trade two goes in, right up here with two lots, this stop comes to break even, minimum, right? So you're here at break even, and you can see you already got 20 pips of profit on trade one, covering the risk, 20 pips of risk on trade two. See, if you think about it, what am I doing? I am lowering my risk. I don't worry about the reward because I don't make a trade unless I know where the reward is. That's the exit. Never make an entry unless you know the exit. Make it a rule, right? Not a guideline. Right? As soon as you make it a rule and you start doing it in 21 days, you'll never do it any other way than that. Why? Because it takes 21 days to develop a habit. Right? But why do I want to do that? Because this solves my risk problem. Yes, I should be trading. I should be stopping the 60 where the bankers are, which would be way down in here. Right? Now, I don't have to do that. Right? I can trade one third of my lots with three times the stop. And I've reduced my risk, and I'm still in position to make the money, right? And I can trade with the big boys if I'll trade like that. If I'll trade like a retail trader, which is trying to grab 10 pips or so with a 30-pip stop, that's silly. As soon as they take out, and all they're trying to do is grab 5 pips, right? And maybe 8 if you're lucky, right? So what happens, okay? Well, let's say 5 pips, okay? So then I make 5 trades. Oh, that's awesome. Then I take a 30-pip loss. All right. Well, that wiped out the 5 trades that I made money on because we only made 25 pips on that. And that wiped that out. I'm actually down 5 pips. All right. So how do I get it back? Well, it's going to take 6 trades in a row for me to get it back. All right. So 5 and 6 is 11. So you have to trade 11 trades in a row without a loss if you have one loss. And it all got to be right. And you can tell right there, well, that means I got to be 90% right. That's right. Can I do that? No, I can't. Not unless you're the greatest trader on the planet. I can't. So don't ever do it. You stack the deck so that you will lose. That's what you've done. So don't do it. And that means you got to have the paradigm shift. And the paradigm shift means that you actually have a paradigm shift. Not talk about it, but actually have one. All right. So what is a paradigm shift? All right. A paradigm shift is an important change that happens when the usual way of thinking about or doing something is, key word here, replace. Replace. You don't keep your old charts and try to keep your slow stochastic on there and say that if the slow stochastic goes over and I'm going to trade this break, hook, and go on ProAct, all you've done is you've taken a bad strategy and complicated it. Right? Ryan Burns, look this up. Incremental changes bring incremental results. Paradigm shifts bring revolutionary changes. This is why we need a paradigm shift so that we can have a revolutionary change in our trading, right? And until you embrace it, you'll keep doing the same thing, which is lots of bad habits, right? All right, now the pullback is my friend here. So if we get a bounce, we're interested. All right. Don't forget, it's dangerous. Why? Because we are, the announcement came out positive instead of negative. All right. But you can also see here that you got a 1, you got a 2, you got a 3, and now you got a 4. What's next? A 5. And that 5 can go to target. There it is. So watch for the bounce right in this area. Watch for it. You can't trade it unless you already got your entry order in up there. Got your entry order in? You can trade the entry order. If you can't trade if you don't have the entry order on up there, you can't trade the trade. That's a rule. It's not a guideline. It's a rule. I can never make trade one unless trade two is already in. All right? That's it. And I got a tool that figures out if it's a good trade. All right? Does it all for me. I don't have to do a calculator anymore. I don't do all that stuff. I just put the values in and it tells me in less than 20 seconds whether it's a good trade or not, whether it's worthwhile. This tool, by the way, if you got trading friends, share this tool, because although they won't, they'll get, everybody will get the alerts in the for a week or two. Everybody will get the ATR for a week or two. All right. Then they go away because there's a cost to us. We have costs in those two things. All right. So the alerts are a time factor for me, and the alerts are a time factor for, and the ATR is a time factor from Jerry. Yeah, we got to stop whatever we're doing every single day, get home, get to our computer, and I got to put alerts out. Jerry's got to get home and redo the ATR, all right? So it's a pain for us to do it, but we do it because it's absolutely necessary if you're going to trade, to know where your risk is and your reward. So that's why we do it. But you can share it, and all these other tools on here would stay there. The risk calculator, the stop calculator, the trip calculator, the must-see videos, fast track they won't see. All these things are still part of this tool, right? So the two major things, alerts and ATR, those are reserved for our subscribers, obviously. All right, there's a value add. Will you get alerts at some at MT4? No. Will you get an ATR in a nice little fashion that you can access it every day? No. You can put the ATR in MT4, but now you got to do that work. All right. It'll take you a while. But it changes every day too, so it has to be changed every day. Not getting a bounce yet. Waiting for a bounce there. I do like these colors. I like these colors a lot. All right, we're waiting. Only two currencies, dollar yen, nothing happening, and pound yen. That's all we got, dollar yen and pound yen. That's it, and EJ, if it will get there, but I don't think it's going to get there. I just said the worst word in Forex, think. All right. I don't think it's going to get there. Uh-oh, Scott, you just said think. Don't do that. All right? So I've trained myself that if I ever say, I think it's going this, I immediately, my left brain says, you just said the worst word in Forex. I've trained myself to do that. All right? Just like I've trained myself to put the fibs on, and I go, stop. Make sure they know the numbers. All right? You got to do whatever it takes to make sure that you execute. All right? All right, we'll see. Quiet day again. It's been a quiet week. Real quiet week. And if you're still not doing pullbacks, I did a video yesterday. Fast track, but here we go. Here. Copy link. All right, you might want to watch this. Take about 20 minutes, but about how to do pullbacks. All right. And why you should do pullbacks. If you're not doing pullbacks, it's the number one thing you should be doing besides polls. Right? Why should I do that? Well, because polls and pullbacks happen every day. Do what they do every day. Get consistent at it. Get confident in it. Become world class in polls. Become world class in pullbacks. And now you can earn while you learn. Right? Yeah, there's lots to learn. But you can still have success while you're learning. If you'll become world class in two things, one is polls and one is pullbacks, because they do them every day. I don't know if they do them every day. Oh yeah, well, let's see. Down we go, pullback. Down we go, pullback. Down we go, pullback. Are we going down? I don't know. Chart's starting to show that we might go down. We might go down. We might go down. We were going down, still trying to push up here. Remember, with dollar is not reacting to that announcement. If the dollar reacts to the announcement and does go up, this is going to go down. Right, so be real. That's why you want to say, okay, below here, I'm a seller. I'm not a buyer unless I can break up here. What does that do? It reduces your risk. Yeah, but there were four more pips in here, man. I could have got four more pips. You don't think care about that. Those aren't your pips. The pips are, that are yours are above this line. That's it. We'll see. There are other people's pips. OPP. OPP. And with this conflict, I don't know. They might not. They're probably not going to move it, but because it's a conflict for them. See, it's a total conflict. Dollar should be going down. It isn't. Hold on, Larry. It's a big one, yeah. It's definitely a big one. It's not one you, because that's really a day chart pennant, right, Larry? So we trade intraday, so we don't have to worry about it. But it's good to know it. I like the way you're thinking, by the way. And they did take the square up out. That was nice. Yeah. So you can see on Larry's chart, the reality is this is what we're doing. That's what they're really doing right there. All right. So, you know, already took the bottom off. So where should they go? Up to the top. When they take the top off, where should they go? Back to the bottom. All right, just like over here. Took the bottom off, went up to the top. Took the top off, went down to the bottom. Went up to the, now we're on our way up to the top. See? So that's the structure. Up, down, up, down. All right. Good work, Larry, as usual. All right, we're getting a bounce. I don't know that I'm interested in it, but we are getting a bounce. They sure like that level right there. They sure like it, as you can see. It's definitely a significant level. They find buyers every time they hit that number. Buyers, buyers, buyers. What's that? That's information. That's information. All right. Now, you got an arrow now. All right. So there's nothing wrong with trading this, but you can trade 1/3 of your lots anytime you want. Anytime you want, because you reduce your risk. If you haven't reduced your risk and you're trading three lots, then you can't trade this thing, right? Because it has too much risk in it, because it's going opposite of what the announcement was, right? Now, they ignore announcements all the time. So, you know, be aware, right? So if we see it turn bright green again, or maybe a white dot, which tells us the 60-minute boys came in, if you see that, then it might be an opportunity. See the information? Yeah, we're trying to push it up. Yeah, we're trying to push it up. What's that? Yeah, we're, this is our bottom right here. We're trying to push it up. Trade two is up here. I already got an entry order in for that. The question is, do I want to take trade one here? Well, I can trade one anytime I want because it's only 1/3 of my lots. Do I have enough information to take this? Yeah, I got a breakout, a hook, and I got a support already in play outside the breakout right there. I know the big boys have come in to try to make this happen. All right, see, and I got plenty of room to the target. What do I need for confirmation? Nothing. I have the confirmation. All right, this is what happens to a lot of traders. They think confirmation is make sure you're already moving. But what happens is if you wait for that to happen, yeah, gold is starting to rise. Canary in the coal mine. There you go, Joe. That's a good sign for a U.S. dollar, too. Gold is starting to rise. So what traders do is they're on an emotional roller coaster. And the reason they're on an emotional roller coaster is because they're not confident in their ability to analyze the market. And the reason they're not confident in their ability to answer the market is because they haven't done the work. So the way traders do it, which is totally wrong, right? The way traders do it is that they go, okay, it looks like, it looks pretty good, man. Oh, come on, let's go, okay. Oh, yeah, it's going to go, okay, I'm in. And where'd you buy? Right at the top. You bought at the top of a bull market. Successful traders recognize this is the point of maximum financial risk. And what did we just do? We bought at the top, at the maximum financial risk, right? And then we go, oh, man, no, it's going to go up. I know. Oh, man, why did I ever trade that thing? Oh, no, it's really going against me. Oh, no, I'm going to get out. I'm getting out. I'm out. Now, successful traders recognize this as the point of maximum financial opportunity. You bailed at the best place to be buying. You bought up here at the worst place to be buying. Oh, yeah, maybe it is going up. No, oh, it's going up. Okay, I'm in. Oh, man, I got creamed. Broker stopped me out again. No, you're buying at the top. You're buying at the top. Why? I need more confirmation. I need more confirmation. No, you don't. Get the stuff on the charts. Get it on the charts. And your confirmation is, I got a break and a hook already. I already had big boys pushing it. I'm out of here. And the risk problem today is the fundy. It's not the structure of the market. The market is structured to do it. See? Go look at gold. All right. So, yeah, gold making a move up, this down. That tells you they believe that dollar is going to break and go down. All right. There you go. So Abdul's probably already made 1,000 pips on gold overnight, knowing Abdul. He trades it virtually every day. We'll see. What's the information coming in? Notice the white dot as the big boys trying to push it down. Right? Over here, they were trying to push it down. Okay, we'll break out. Okay, let's go get it. Okay, now we're done. Let's go. Let's go back to what we were doing, which is trading this big old range down here. And it's a big range, as you can see. Lots of opportunity to the downside. How much is there to the upside? Not much. Where's the opportunity for a big boy? To the downside. See that? Not to the upside. There's no room up there. But to the downside, there is. So watch for them to push it out. Right? It's all common sense. It's all sensible. Right? Down the end, what are you going to do? Nothing. DJ, you going to get up there? Nope. Dollar yen. You going to do anything? Nope. What a mess. Welcome to trading. Right. So most of the time, you're sitting on your hands. Most of the time. Where's the trade? Where's the trade? I just want to make a trade, man. Where's the trade?
Hey, you pushed the button. I didn't tell him to push the button. Did you tell him to push the button? Oh, I didn't tell him to push the button. I didn't tell him to push the button. You shouldn't just go push a button. You don't go around pushing strange buttons. I tell you, don't push the button.
Go. Don't press the button. Wait for the trade to come to you. Is it coming yet? Nope. So what should I do? Sit on your hands. GA's going down. Thanks for the heads up. Okay. Yeah, we already did our ATR though, Sabitri. Remember this. If you've done your ATR, in order to get the trade to the downside, it would have to do the ATR up. And let me change that. ATR up. And then ATR down, all right? Now that's double the ATR, all right? So is that reasonable? It's not reasonable. It can happen. It's possible. It's just not probable, all right? So pound Aussie has an ATR of 94 pips. Its average is 112, all right? So it did the 112, as you can see right there. So, or 120 actually is probably what it is. I bet it did 120. What do you bet? Let's go cheap. It changes to 120, which is what it was doing. Yep, it did 120. See that? That's why you want this number. All right? I want that number. All right? So if it blows through, I know how far it can go. Well, it can go 120. This is what it was doing 90 days ago. All right? And it did 120 to the pip, basically. All right? So is it feasible to go up 120 pips and down 120 pips, which is a total of 240 pips, when its average is 112? See that? So could it do it? Sure, it's possible. Should I count on it doing it? No, because the numbers don't work. They'll probably give it all back, but it's not tradable. It's not tradable. You can watch it, but it's not tradable. Once you do the ATR in one direction, don't trade it. Right? Now, if you haven't done it, you get a pullback, trade it to the, and you got room, trade it to the ATR, because it's a statistical probability every single day. Right? So, what is it? The ATR is technical analysis volatility indicator. It indicates the volatility or the variation of trading price series over time. Right? So that's what it is. Right? Wilder invented it. So what is it? The range of the day's trading is simply the high minus the low. So what I'm trying to do when I put the ATR on is find the high and the low of the day chart candle that is in my future. Where is the high and the low of the day chart candle before it happens? That's what ATR does for you. All right, see that? So at the end of the day on this chart, if it goes all the way up here and comes all the way down, it won't matter because this is the day chart candle, both up and down. See that? See that, Savitri? Does that make sense? That's a great question. I mean, you spurred on a great question is what you did. All right, we're waiting. Surprise, surprise. Just not getting any traction. See that? We're just hanging out, not getting any traction to the upside. All right. So I'll leave my entry order in, and later on today it may roll on up there. All right. If it does, I press my winners because we got two lots up there. I'd like to get three, but I still have two lots, so I did press my winners in that area. I didn't get trade one. It's okay. Not always going to get them. UJ's moving some. There we go, a little bit. Maybe we'll get this now. Right. Remember, this matter, the dollar is the base currency here. Right. So the dollar is moving. If this breaks to the downside, watch that UJ fly. Right. So if it breaks, all right. So, wow, I know that right now. So do I have my entry order in down here? Do you have your entry order at 150.98 or 150.96? Do you have that entry order in? If you do, you can trade it. If you don't, you can't. All right, I got a pending order in on UJ also, this area right here with two lots. And now we wait and see. Should I take it above that support? No, tells you right now, don't take it. Why? That's a bounce point. We bounce on that line. We bounce on this line. Oh, I'll take it now. No, we bounce on that line. All right, what do I need? I need a break, hook, and go. They've already probed it once and there weren't any entry orders down here. So that's what that wick is a probe to see where the entry orders are. All right. So they knew they didn't have any. That's why they went back up to find some sellers. They found sellers. Down they come. But now we set a support. Oh, okay. We can't break it. Up we go again. We're going to try again. All right. If we break through here, we're going to look for entry orders. All right. So we don't want that. We want to break, hook, and go. Prove you're going down and not just a probe. See? So we want to measure on the risk side. Yeah, but what if it goes? Then I got my two trades down here. I'm good. If it goes, I just didn't get trade one. But I didn't risk money on a high risk trade. I only risk money when it proves it can do it. And that's when it's that way it's down here. See, if you think through it logically, you go, well, this makes total sense. Absolutely, it does. Why does it make total sense? Because it takes care of my risk. Most retail traders, all they're looking for is a reward. Where's my, it's going up, I'm up 8 pips, oh, it's going back, oh my God, clicking it out, there we go, okay. I made 8 pips today, yay, I'm a winner. Yep, you're a winner, you won the battle. You just lost the war. You gotta be 90% correct for the rest of your life now. What? Yeah, you can't do that. You can't do it, you gotta stop it, snuff it out. We'll see. It's still hanging here. Again, I'm leery of it because of the fundamental announcement, which the gorilla in the room today is fundamental announcement. Will they ignore it or will they accept it? Right now, it looks like they're still contemplating. They haven't chosen either way. We do have a little channel started, a little one. Not even that big. Pretty little. There we go. Heartline proven perfectly there. All right. Now we're at the point where they have to talk to us. You have to talk to us here, Mr. Currency. All right. Right here. You're either going to break it out to the downside or you're going to bounce it to the upside. All right. If they break it out, I need a break hook and go. How long does that take? 20 minutes. Can I, in 20 minutes, figure out where it's going to the downside? Yes, I can. All right. So this is where they got to talk to us. You either bounce or you break out. One or the other. All right. In the meantime, I'm waiting. You see, this is just a big old Darvis box. So the 240. So this is a big Darvis box right here. All right. So if I came into the Darvis box going down, that means I'm coming out going down. Everybody see that? All right. So, do I want to keep this channel on here? I don't. All right. I want to see this trade. And you can see, overall, the structure is to the downside. Now, today, it may be to the upside. But you can also see where the problem is here, that they got to break this top right there. And we haven't broken it yet. And that's trade two right there. So, you can see, it's a dicey trade, folks. It's dicey. There's a lot of confirmation to the downside, right? But what do? Well, I'm really leery of taking the buy, especially with the dollar going down. And now you see in the closing reverse here, right? So now it's making more sense. If we come back in here, let me redraw this line like this now and include that. I'm going to take this off, right? And now, it's pushing through. If it pushes on through here, this will be the high for the day. We'll flip it over. Right? Could be. That's a 60. It's actually not a 100 moving average. It's a 60. So it held it there. Held it here. Look at how many times that 60 held it. Held it here. All right. Now, what do we know? All right. Take a look at it. Does this make sense now? It does. All right. Let's go look at the Three Musketeers. All right. What do the Three Musketeers say? And they say, we're trying to go nowhere. We're trying to turn it down. No, we're still going up. We're going sideways. We're closing to go down. And we're closing to go. And we already closed down. All right. Confirmer says, don't even think about it yet. All right. So more and more, it looks like they're going to follow the fundamental. Right? So this is why you sit on your hands. Let it prove it. Right? Now, if we just go on a trade, there it is. It's going. I'm in. We're upside down now if you do that stuff. That's why we don't do that stuff. All right. What's the ATR? 133 pips. Okay. So that's the ATR. This will be the new high for the day. 133 pips to the downside. And we'll see if we can trade it. Down. Yes, we can. All right. Now, you can see it's dicey in here. Right in here. This is the whole trade to the downside. But this is dicey right there. See that? So, what does that tell you? Okay, that tells me that trade two is below here. There's trade two. Here's trade one right there. Right, and you're showing you they're going to do it. Right, and now, it's, remember, it didn't make sense to the upside because the dollar was going down. Right? Now, up, I should say. Now, the dollar is saying it's going down. This should break up. It's not doing that. Right? So what is it telling you? Be cautious. Be cautious. Don't be in a hurry here. Now, if dollar yen goes down, that makes all sense in the world because the dollar is the base currency here, all right? And they're attempting to break it again. Remember, we need a break, hook, and go here. What's our problem? Time of day. We got 9 minutes to 11 o'clock. Thank you, Daniel. All right. Do I want a yen cross, which isn't going to move until the Asian market? Do I want to at all right now, this late today? It's 8:30 in the morning. I'm all over it. 11 o'clock, I'm not interested, right? Which means I don't have a trade today. Is that okay? Yeah, that's okay. We didn't risk our money because nothing warranted the risk. Nothing on the charts warranted the risk. So we passed. And the average retail trader thinks there's trades all over the place. There's trades everywhere, man. The candles are moving. There's got to be a trade. Well, if you think about five pips, yeah, there's thousands of five pip trades all day, every day. Right? But what happens if I do that? I got to be 90% correct for the rest of my life. I have to be the best trader on the planet. Am I the best trader on the planet? No, I'm not. Therefore, I can't do it. Right? So watch for that tonight. Now, most likely what they're going to do is they're going to telegraph, right? They telegraph all the time, and especially at the end of the session. So at the end of the session, all they're trying to do is whatever barrier they were trying to break in this session, they finally break it. They wait till the market dies down. Everybody says, I'm not going to trade today. I'm done. And now it takes very little money to push that out. All right. Yeah. You know, it's in the millions of dollars, but that's very small for them. And then all they want to do is open and close a candle under here. Now, if they could open and close the candle, they kept the agenda in play, which says we're going down, right? So most likely, that's what's going to happen right now, right? Which means it's going nowhere, right? So do I want this trade? I don't want this trade. Do I want this pound yen? No, not this time of day. Right. Now you can see, what are they doing? They're trying to get it here, break here, open and close the candle down here. All right. If they can do that, then they have accomplished telling everybody what they're trying to do. Remember, they have to tell everybody what they're trying to do. Why do they have to do that? Because they can't call each other up and say, "Hi, Bank America, this is HSBC. We're trying to take that pound yen down to 198. Would you go help us?" No. They can't do that. That's price fixing. So how do they do it? They do it in the charts. That means the information is available to every trader on the planet who knows what to look for. All right? And that's the journey of becoming a trader, is learning what to look for. Where are the clues? All right? And every day there are clues. All right? Your job is to find them. What are the clues? What adds up to be a seller or buy? What if it doesn't add up? Then I don't trade. It's not high enough for a buy. It's not high enough for a sell. All right. Now we're getting lots of information. It's a sell. But now the time of day is a piece of information that says don't even think about it. All they're trying to do is telegraph. All right. Now, pound yen is correlated opposite of the dollar index. Right, down your correlations down here. Pop it up, and you can see right now, pound yen. It does not go with it. It goes opposite. Dollar's coming down. GJ is coming down. What does that mean? Risk, risk, risk. Don't trade it. Not yet. Let it prove it. All right? And you know, you just got to wait, you know, 12 hours or something like that. And now you'll get this big trade down here, especially if they can take this bottom off. They take that bottom off, then it's easy sailing down here. Right? The only thing you got to worry about is this bottom over here. All right? So that would define trade one. And then trade two to wherever the ATR is. See, it's very simple. All right? Don't make it complicated. All right. Got a channel working here now to the downside, so I'll go ahead and put it on. Heartline proven, heartline proven. Yep, there you go. All right. Now, so you might say, well, why didn't you take this to the downside from up here? Why didn't you take this high? I'll show you why. Is that a sustainable trend? No, it's not. See, it's a big trend on the, that's a day chart trend. So, but we don't trade the day chart. So we'll see here. All right. Dollar yen, we got down. No break yet. Right. We got 4 minutes to go to the 11 o'clock bump. Fast trackers, we will not go to market analysis today because we're going to be in the platinum class in about 2 hours. So we'll just, if you got a question, just hold it till then. We'll be there anyway. So found this yesterday. Big opportunity tonight, right there. Sweet. All right, 3 minutes to go. Do we have a trade today? No. Are we upset that we didn't have a trade today? No. If there's no trade, we don't want to trade. All right. That's all there is to it. We're glad we didn't trade. Why? Because there wasn't any. All right. We know where the trade is, but it didn't do that. So therefore, we have nothing to do. And the retail trader thinks, oh my gosh, we should be able to trade all the time. All right. That's the thought process. Well, if I'm gonna be a trader, I gotta go make a trade. No, if you're gonna be a trader, you gotta analyze the market and figure out where's the best risk for reward. And if there isn't any, I don't make a trade today. That's trading. That's trading. Pushing the button takes all of 2 seconds. That's not pushing the button. Don't push the button. Wait for this trade to come to you. Well, it's not here yet. All right, we got 2 minutes to go. And then the barrier options expire, and anything that's close to it, you know, it'll be gone. All right, so it's no longer. See, the barrier option is still a barrier. All right. It's not a line you put on the chart. It's just a level that the bankers have already determined that's where the barrier options are. And they bought puts and calls a month ago for it. And there are million and billion dollar payoffs. So options are the smallest part of the Forex, but the biggest payoff. That's it. One more minute to go, then we'll do a session recap. Pound yen, trying to push through here. So starting to get more and more information. We can take this off to the upside now. We don't need this up there. We need it one to the downside. All right, so you see one, two. All right, so I got to fib that from the swing high to the swing low, back to the swing high, which is a lower high. All right, and there we go. Now there's the 1,000. All right, so as I'm coming down, this is the whole trade right here. We're going to go to the 1.618 down there. As I'm coming down, this could become trade one if you're an advanced trader. If not, trade one is here, right there, to the 1,000. And then trade two is here to the 1.618. All right. Now, you can see there are three spaces there, but trade one is leery because of that support. Right? But you can still make it because it's only 130 or lots. You can make it if you're an advanced trader. You can do it. Not this time of day, but tonight you can do that. So be aware of that. All right. Not getting any movement from the barrier options expiring, as you can see. Nothing happening there. Anything happening here? Nothing happening here yet. Look, they're still respecting that thing. Look at the buys. Immediately off that support. That's why, you know, break, hook, and go is what we need. All right. All righty.